In this lecture, we're going to talk about flow production.
Production and operations management is essentially about how to create and sustain productivity. We can separate between effectiveness and efficiency. While effectiveness is about meeting the intended outcomes, efficiency is about doing so without wasting resources or time. The ideal state of efficiency is flow. We can use the letters in the word flow to separate four foundational principles: flexible systems, leveled processes, overload avoidance, and waste reduction. Flexibility is key to sustained flow. A river is flexible, always seeking the shortest path when earth erodes or water levels rise and sink. A system that is rigged only for one way to operate will be interrupted when conditions change. Flexibility does not mean lack of standards and routines. Quite the opposite, actually. Standards allow a swift transition between states because the laws are defined, just as gravity and fluid mechanics define the path of the river. In manufacturing, productivity is defined by the rate to which units flow through the system. If all the processes in the systems are leveled, that means balanced, the flow is smoother and more efficient. The key to level processes is to first drive out variation. Good companies understand that leveling is an uphill battle that must be fought continuously. Hence, instead of trying to implement it in a project, they develop daily and weekly routines for action and learning. Flow breaks down when any process in the chain is overloaded. Overload effectively kills flow. A machine that is run 100% of its time without maintenance will eventually break down and create flow disturbances. A person who is given far too many tasks will eventually get stressed and sick. A warehouse operated at 98% fill rate is extremely slow and inefficient. The rule of thumb is that processes need some level of slack. Waste can cautiously be defined as anything the customer is not willing to pay for. Reducing waste is an essential part of creating flow, but it is meaningless on its own if not the three principles discussed before are prioritized: flexible systems, level processes, and overload avoidance. Taichi Ono, one of the fathers of the Toyota production system, categorized seven sorts of waste: unnecessary transportation, inventory, motion, waiting, overprocessing, overproduction, and producing defects. Roger Schmenner and Morgan Swink have suggested the theory of swift, even flow, which holds that the more swift and even the flow of materials through a process is, the more productive that process is. So the task of efficiency is to create an uninterrupted, fast, and steady flow of materials through the manufacturing process. While this is not an impossible task in a single process, it is quite challenging for large production and service systems. So, flow is important for productivity. The way to achieve it is to synchronize four M's: man, material, machines, and methods. Next time you make waffles, crepes, or pancakes, think about how the concept of flow can help you increase your efficiency.